My name is Morgan Grandmathen, and I take you to work every morning on the radio. I'm also known as your radio key hero. And I'm very glad that you're here in my audience this evening. If you already heard me on the radio, thank you so much. If you haven't yet, then please, I make that request to you. Having said that, today is of course a very, very August gathering here. I'd like to request you to take your seats first. I see a few of our friends playing around the back. Can you take a seat so that you can start?
Problems in our society. That Me Too movement is making skeletons stumble out of the cupboards, leaving many people confused, scared and skeptical. But the fact is, it is a lived reality of many women, which often stems from male entitlement and lack of systems to call out such behaviors. Let's look at this as an opportunity to confront our own biases and patriarchal mindsets. You will be surprised to see how deeply entrenched they are in us. Let's give women their due respect, acknowledgement, and acceptance as fellow human beings who have a right to choose and be what they want to be. Let this movement not be subverted to reinforce all that is wrong with our society as a backlash to the insecurities, fears, and disturbance that it has caused. Let's not trivialize it. It is a serious issue. As journalists, I request you to make sensitivity not just a part of your writing, but also a part of your life, at home, in the workplaces, everywhere. Call out such behavior so that we could work together unhindered as equals. This is the kind of world we should be building for our ladies. We are also observing Navaratri now, which celebrates multidimensionality of women and the triumph of good over evil spearheaded by women. While I wish you a very happy Dasara, I urge you to bring the diversity that exists in our society into your writing. I know there are commercial interests driving the media business, but still we all can make a difference in our own way. As Sister says, sensitivity does not hurt the bottom lines always. Some of the ads which are gender sensitive and have made a big difference in the way they portray gender issues and were equally successful on the social media drives home this point. Maybe in today's social media context, with heightened sensitivities and multiple voices, sensitivity could make commercial sense also. Just think of it. I'm glad to know that each one of you has told a story, raised an issue, questioned the current state of affairs, and has shown mirror to all of us about the misogyny, biases, and discrimination that pervade our society. More power to you. Reading the entries was an enriching experience. You are the role models for others. May more and more people be inspired by your work to make journalism and communication in general more responsible and meaningful. Once again, a big thank you to all of you and each and every one who has supported us in our movement to promote gender sensitivity in the media. Thanks, Sita. Thank you. And our first award. Congratulations. Our next award is for Best Teacher.
picture. This is for when women fight their own battles. That was in the HuffPost.in. This is for Adrija Bose. Give her a big hand, ladies and gentlemen. For a well-crafted and empathetic features addressing diverse issues, ranging from women with pregnancies to mental health issues, especially for women, to the feel-good story on a girls' football team in Haryana, Adrija Bose is presented the South Asia Lali Media Award for Gender Sensibility 2017.
Thank you.
does deserve a standing ovation for the contribution that she has made to music. I realize again that achievement is an ongoing, never-ending process on the path of excellence. Name, fame, money, awards, glamour are indeed a part of the achievement. They definitely take one a long way with renewed vigor and enthusiasm towards chosen pursuit. But to be able to keep walking on this unending path of excellence till the last breath is in itself the greatest award. I pray God to give me strength and keep me walking on this path. Music is my profession. However, for the last more than 25 years, I have been actively involved in different capacities in the working of the Rastapeti Education Society at Pune, which is a 91-year-old educational institution. This society caters to the children from the backward community, underprivileged and marginalized sections of the eastern part of Pune. I suppose this involvement of mine is close to the work area of population first.
Hi, I'm Aisha, lovely George. So I work with Hidden Pockets. तो हिडन पॉकेट्स में हम लोग एक ऐसा प्लेटफॉर्म है जहाँ पर हम विमेन को सर्विस प्रोवाइडर्स जैसे डॉक्टर्स, काउंसलर्स और एडवोकेट्स जो कि सेक्सुअल एंड रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ में काम करते हैं उनसे मिलवाते हैं. तो इसी के साथ वी ऑल्सो क्रिएट पॉडकास्ट होते हैं जो ऑडियो क्लिप होते हैं जो ऑनलाइन में डाल सकते हैं और जैसे हम गाना सुनते हैं वो अपने मोबाइल में भी रख सकते हैं. तो उसके साथ हम लोग पॉडकास्ट भी बनाते हैं. सो हमने एक पॉडकास्ट बनाया जिसे कहते हैं पॉकेट शाला. और ये पॉकेट शाला गवर्नमेंट स्कूल के बच्चों के लिए और जो रैग पिकर बच्चे हैं जो स्लम में बच्चे रहते हैं उनके लिए हमने बनाया था ताकि हम टॉपिक जो कि बुलिंग से लेके अपने शरीर से लेके और रिलेशनशिप लेके जो बच्चों के बीच में बातें उठती हैं बट कहीं से दब जाती है उस टॉपिक से रिलेटेड हमने एक छोटा सा पॉकेट शाला ऑडियो टेप बनाया जहाँ पर सेटअप स्कूल का है और बच्चे एक दूसरे से बात कर रहे हैं. तो हम इस पॉकेट शाला को इस ऑडियो टेप को ले गए गवर्नमेंट स्कूल जहाँ पर टीचर्स को थोड़ी हिचकिचाहट होती है बच्चों से इस सब टॉपिक के बारे में बात करने के लिए. तो हम वहाँ ले गए ताकि ये बजाने के बाद टीचर्स को थोड़ा सा यू नो दे विल फील कम्फर्टेबल और वो बच्चों से कहीं ना कहीं बात कर पाएंगे इन टॉपिक्स के बारे में. तो आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक दिस प्लेटफॉर्म. आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक पॉपुलेशन फर्स्ट एंड लाडली अवार्ड क्योंकि जब एक अवार्ड मिलता है और रिकग्नाइज करते हैं तो यू फील बेटर. आई मीन तुमको एक हौसला मिलता है कि मेरे काम को अप्रिशिएट किया गया है और एक हौसला मिलता है और टीम को भी हौसला मिलता है कुछ और बेटर करने का. सो आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक लाडली एंड पॉपुलेशन फर्स्ट फॉर गिविंग अस दिस अवार्ड. थैंक यू.